This week on What's New
EDU. Ooh.
What's up, everybody? What's New in EDU is back in your world. I'm Tony, a fourth grade teacher and classroom superhero from Hackensack, New Jersey. Microsoft asked me to give you the scoop into all their news, updates, and features from this really cool event called BET. And if you didn't see the previous episode, go take a look. Well, maybe after this. Today, we're talking all about Office 365 education and Skype in the classroom. Let's go talk to Mike and see what he has for us.
Thanks, Tony. Now, in the modern classroom, we know there's a lot of diversity. We know that there are up to 4 levels of reading in a single classroom. There's also 3/4 of all classrooms have at least 1 or more special education students in the general population. Then we also know that over half of classrooms have at least 1 non-native speaker. So in that diverse environment, Microsoft is really focusing on the inclusive classroom. We have a bunch of announcements that we're going to talk about today. The first one, the one I'm most excited about, is Office now has built-in dictation. So I'm going to put on this headset, which is always great for the most accuracy, and I'm going to go up here and click the dictate button. Microsoft Office has built-in dictation. There we go. And it's not just in Word, it's also in PowerPoint. There's also a dictate button. So we're bringing this across Office into Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote, and also Word Online and OneNote Online. Beyond just dictation, we're announcing learning tools coming to many more platforms. So we're bringing it to OneNote on the iPad, OneNote for Mac, Word Mac, Office Lens for Android. Edge is getting more capabilities. So we're really bringing learning tools across all of Office and Windows to make it mainstream, non-stigmatizing, and built in. Now the other big announcement I'm going to talk about today is one of my favorites. We have some OneNote stuff coming out. So on the OneNote side, we have the number one most requested feature of the past couple of years for class notebooks, which is the ability for a teacher to lock a page. So that means this teacher can give all this feedback and then lock all the pages so the student can't change it afterwards. So teachers all around the world have been asking for that, and we're excited to give it to you. The other big announcement we have is Capita SIMS, which is the top SIS, MIS in the UK. We now have assignment and grade integration with Capita SIMS coming out very soon. And then we also announced, lastly, that we have Desmos integration. Desmos Math is one of the most popular scientific calculators for the classroom. And so STEM teachers around the world can celebrate because we know they've been asking for Desmos integration. So that's all integrated, ready to go. So there you have it, Tony. A bunch of tools for your classroom. Thanks.
Awesome. Thanks, Mike. Now let's switch gears to Skype in the classroom. I've had a chance to use it. I'll be using it next week when I get back. The online community is amazing, and it enables teachers like me to inspire the next generation of global citizens through transformative learning over Skype. So let's go talk to Eero. She has an event you're not gonna wanna miss.
It's awesome that you're already using Skype, Tony. As educators, you all know that literacy is a foundation of education and one of the most important skills for a child's success in school and life. But how can you really bring literacy to life for your students? Did you know that you can invite an author, illustrator, and storyteller live into your classroom via Skype? Yes, it's true. Every year, Skype in the Classroom celebrates literacy globally and gives you an opportunity to break down the walls of your classrooms and inspire the next generation of readers and writers, no matter where you are in the world. Join us this year on World Read Aloud Day, February 1st, as we kick off a month to celebrate literacy with live connections. And let the magic begin. Back to you, Tony.
As soon as I get home, I'm going to hit up an author and read to my kiddos on February 1st. Now, Microsoft Teams is an amazing digital hub that brings conversations, content, and apps together in one place. Let's go chat with Yusuf from Microsoft Teams and Kathy, an educator from Perth, Australia. They have some exciting news in store.
Thanks, Tony. Last year, we met Kathy at BET, and this year, we are so excited to welcome her back to share her school systems transformation using Microsoft Teams. Kathy, tell us a little bit more about what you've been sharing with our BET audience this week.
for us with Teams, it's all about reducing fragmentation of attention and fragmentation of experience. So Teams brings people together, and Teams brings their apps and their communication and their resources together so they can focus on themselves and each other and getting the work done that they need to do.
Awesome. Now, tell us a little bit more about the virtual classroom experience that you're building out for your school system.
We're very excited about our virtual school. We've got students in very remote schools who don't have access to certain courses in their own school. So now we have 70 students coming together with 14 teachers, all from different schools, and they'll be learning from specialist teachers. They've got that combination of the synchronous Skype conversations, so they don't have any isolation feeling, and the ability to continue their learning using the class notebook.
That's excellent to see all the Office 365 apps coming together in the Teams Hub for a virtual environment. Now, oftentimes we think of Teams with classroom collaboration with students and teachers, but how are educators using Teams for professional learning and development?
Right, so we want to make sure that teachers and staff get continual learning opportunities so that they can stay up to date.
Yeah.
And so we use them for professional learning communities where teachers can come together with other colleagues who share an interest. We use them for school improvement so that schools can work on their problems of practice and even bring in external experts who might be able to contribute to the work that they're doing.
Yeah.
And we use it for formal adult learning courses where teachers actually want to acquire a skill that will help them in their practice.
That's excellent to hear about not only students using Teams, but educators and school leaders too, in just a diverse set of ways. Thanks, Kathy. Now, before we go, I want to show you guys three new updates that we have coming to Teams. First, assignments on mobile. Now with Teams on mobile, students can turn in their homework assignments and check their grades. The fun doesn't stop there. Teachers can also create assignments and grade assignments all from their mobile and tablet devices. Second, we have multiple class distribution with Teams. Now a teacher can create one assignment and push it over to multiple classes on their Teams platform. And then finally, new education apps coming to Teams. Everything from checking attendance to creating flashcards and digital quizzes to even visualizing student achievement data. Make sure to check out the Microsoft Teams Tech Community blog to get a list of these new apps coming to your Teams platform. That's it. Thanks, Tony.
Thanks. Now look, if this is new to you or you want to learn where to start using technology in the classroom, here's my advice. Start small. Focus on one thing. First, maybe use Skype in the classroom to participate in World Read Aloud Day, February 1st. Try out OneNote in your classroom, or even just start a team with your fellow teachers and see how it goes. From my experience, I've learned that whatever you do, Microsoft is here to support you. Now stick with me. We have so much more that we'll be covering all week. Make sure to tune in live on Facebook at 4 p.m. London time every day. We'll see ya.
See you next time!